Welcome to the Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracle's RPA Center of Excellence.
Hi everyone, myself Usha Kiranmai, working as RPA developer in Miracle Innovation Labs. Today I would like to discuss on robotic desktop automation using UiPath. These are the concepts which I'm going to cover in this video. What do we mean by robots? What is robotic desktop automation, RPA versus RDA, and business use case overview, and architectural flow followed by live demo. Let us move on to the first slide. So in this slide, I'm going to discuss about robotic process automation. So RPA is the use of software combined with both artificial intelligence and machine learning capabilities to handle high volume repeatable tasks like queries, calculation, and maintenance of records and transactions. RPA technology, sometimes called a software robot or bot, mimics a human interaction, work like logging into applications, entering data, calculating and completing tasks, and logging out. So it is a solution to automate the day-to-day manual tasks performed by configuration analysts. So this technology can help organizations on the digital transformation journeys by enabling better customer service, ensuring business operations and processes comply with regulations and standards, allowing process to be completed much more rapidly, providing improved efficiency by digitalizing and auditing process data, creating cost savings for manual and repetitive tasks, enabling employees to be more productive. We'll see what is robotic desktop automation in our next slide. So robotic desktop automation is also called the attended automation. During the automation execution, the robot can reach and control to the person in front of the workstation if necessary, so that the person can make a decision that requires his intelligence or business experience. This aspect of the robot acting like a human being software assistant interacting with the workstation while complying with business logic can be RPA. By using this RDA, we can deliver digital workforce. That means desktop automation reduces the demands on your agents. In addition, the same automation technology can be deployed into the back office to further automate manual process. That means complete RPA without human intervention. Now we'll see what's the difference between RPA versus RDA. RPA, initially we'll speak about RPA, also called as unattended automation, and it is the automation without human intervention while executing the robot. The robot is scheduled to run automatically, and if the application or system is logged off, the robot is capable of logging back into the system and run the automation task. So this type of robot is self-triggered. Unattended automation is used for back office system. So when robots have dedicated servers to be placed and scheduled for run the process that involve large amounts of data which need to be gathered, stored, analyzed among the business level. So coming to robotic desktop automation, this automation is called front office automation, and this requires human intervention. So these robots are present in the employee system itself and are triggered when specific events are run at a scheduled time. We got the basics required to understand this use case, and we'll see the business overview for this use case. So in this slide, I'm going to speak about the business use case overview. So in this, we have two processes. The first one is customer process and second one is vendor process. In customer process, customer needs to send a purchase order document to the vendor. This document is a legally binding document between the supplier and a buyer. So this document contains PO numbers, purchase order data, vendor details, and item details. Coming to the vendor process, a vendor needs to approve the quantity based on the requested quantity and availability. So this is done through a .NET based Windows application. So all the purchase order related data that is extracted by the robot, which is available on this application. Once the approval process is complete, user triggers an attended bot to make a log of the data onto the mainframe application. So we'll see the business process diagram regarding to this use case. So this is the business process flow. So coming to this flow of vendor process, which consists of two bots, the bot one and bot two and vendor process. So regarding components, if we discuss, the bot one comprises of UiPath, which is automation tool, and DBS SQL server. Vendor components are Windows form and bat submit. So bot two, which comprises of UiPath automation tool and mainframe system. Now we'll move on to the architecture diagram. So this is the architectural flow for our use case. So initially the robot starts automating the task here. So initially it fetches the purchase order docs from the local folder and it extracts the data and stores into SQL DB. Now the vendor needs to open up the Windows form for data validation, where the Windows form is a .NET based application. So the vendor will approve or reject the quantity according to the purchase order. So if PO exists, then this loop runs continuously, which we discussed previously. If it doesn't exist, then it will be prompted to batch submit. So vendor need to perform batch submit to trigger bot. Once it triggers, it logons into the mainframe application and pushes the updated data from SQL DB into mainframe application. Next, if PO exists, then this loop runs continuously. If it doesn't exist, the robot stops executing the flow. So this is the architectural flow for the use case. Now let us see the live demo for this use case. Now we'll see the live demo of robotic desktop automation with UiPath. So this is the VOMA flow. This is the flow which we have created for our use case. Now let us run this. So now, as we discussed it previously, the bot one will run. So it opens the purchase order document and it extracts the fields like vendor address, to which address it ships to, item number, description, unit price, quantity. So these are all the fields which it going to extract. So this is the first purchase order document. So once it extraction completes, it will closes that PDF and it opens another purchase order document. So this loop continues until we have number of purchase orders in that particular folder. So this is the second purchase order which we are looking into. Now the extraction was done. So if we look into our SQL database, so once it extracts all the fields, it will be storing into our SQL database. So if you click on dbo.transaction table, if you refresh this, so these are all the fields which was extracted and kept into this dbo.transaction table. Purchase order number, item number, quantity, and approved quantity. So this approved quantity will be approved by the vendor. So we will see in the next step. So if you click on dbo.purchase order, we have here purchase order number, date, vendor name, to which address it ships to, delivery date. So if you click on dbo.item, so it extracts these fields, item number, item description, and the item price. So these are all the data for only two PDFs. So if you have more than that, it will extract those also. So now before triggering the second bot, we need to the vendor need to approve all these item quantities. So for that, we need to click on start. When we click on start, we can see here the application, which is in the form of .NET. It is completely .NET based application. So here the vendor need to approve all those items. So we have only two purchase orders. So if we click on first one, so that whole data related to that will be visible here. So I will be approving this quantity. So once we approve that, we need to click on submit button so that this data will be updated in our SQL database. So again, I'm approving this quantity also. So unfortunately, the first one hasn't got approved. So I'm again, yes. Now this item numbers got approved. So I'm moving for second purchase order. So I'm giving 7 here. So once you approve, we need to enter the submit button. So here the vendor is providing manual process, that means approving manually. So we don't have any purchase orders here, so we will be prompting to batch submit. So when we click on batch submit, the second bot will trigger. So what we see up to now is called the robotic desktop automation, also called front office automation. So when we click on batch submit, now the second bot triggered and it was entering into the mainframe application by providing the credential. So the data will be entered into this mainframe application, which we got approved previously. So these are all the items which we approved in our .NET based application. So this is the second purchase order data. Yes, so it's done. So it successfully enters the data into the mainframe application. So this is the demo part for our use case.
Thank you for watching The Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracles RPA Command Center. For more about automation, please visit miraclesoft.com/RPA.